हाय हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज सुरेश, लेक्चरर इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक चेगुंटा। आई एम गोइंग टू डील विथ ए सब्जेक्ट कॉल्ड एडवांस्ड वर्कशॉप टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर सेकेंड सेमेस्टर। सो द मेजर टॉपिक इज फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स। सो फ्रॉम दिस I am going to deal with this topic called hot working processes. So we can recap our previous class once. So in previous classes we have learned about the hot working. Okay. So hot working, which is done at above recrystallization temperature. Okay, and also the some types of hot workings, such as hot rolling, extrusion, forging and hot drawing. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about the few more hot working processes, such as forging, hot piercing, hot rolling, hot spinning, okay, and hot reeling, hot drawing. Okay, so all these are we have discussed today, right? So third one, that already we have discussed two hard working process in previous videos. So now I am going to continue with the third one, that is forging. Okay, so hard working process forging, it is a process that involves shaping of heated metal by hammering and pressing. So whatever the components you want to make them into some shapes, required shapes or desired shapes, so that metal should be heated and then hammered by a hammers, and also you can use pressing by the some hydraulic pressing machines. Next, so forging is the oldest working process. Okay, this is the one of the oldest metal working processes. Okay, so works above the recrystallization temperature. Okay, this forging works above the recrystallization temperature. Next, we can see the diagram here. So this is the forging section. So we can observe the hot metal processes we can see here in these machines. Right, so you can see some of the examples for forging. Okay, the forging process used to spanners, bolts, nuts. So you can see the words draw forged on spanner. Okay, so you can next knives. Okay, so next one is knives. Next, third one, gold rings, chains. Okay, so joining up two metal pieces, example block cut rim. Agriculture tools. Okay, so next one is hot piercing. Okay, so hot piercing, you can see here. So hot piercing is used to produce seamless tubes. Okay, this hot piercing is used to produce seamless tubes. A small hole is made at the end of heated billet. A small hole is made at the end of heated billet, and it is fed between two piercing rolls. Okay, so it is fed between the two piercing rolls, that is double cone shaped, obliquely aligned. Okay, so piercing rolls rotating in the same direction. Okay, it is fed between the two piercing rolls rotating in the same direction. Next, the action of the rolls causes the billets to revolve. The action of rolls causes the billets to revolve about its own axis. Okay, and to fade in the direction of the mandrel. Okay, next, as a result, seamless tubes is produced. So the action of the rolls caused the billets to revolve and feed in the direction of mandrel. So this results a seamless tubes is produced. Okay, so you can see the diagram here. This is the diagram of a so heart piercing. Okay, so you can observe the parts here. Solid billet. Okay, solid billet, so pointed mandrel and roughly formed tube. So both the piercing rolls are rotated in the same direction. Okay, you can observe the figure here. Okay, so in this figure it is clearly shows the direction of rotation of the piercing rollers, that is tapered piercing rollers. Okay, just we have to pass the solid billet between the two hot piercing rollers so that we can extrude the solid billet into a tubes, so seamless tubes. Okay, so next one is products of heart piercing. So we can see the products prepared by the heart piercing process. So tubes of brass, copper, steels, okay, aluminium and various alloys metals. So all these are the tubes prepared by the heart piercing processes. So by using a different metals, so brass, copper, steels, aluminium and various alloy metals. Okay, so next one is heart reeling. Next one is heart reeling. You can see here. So this heart reeling is similar in principle of, okay, so this heart reeling is similar in principle to the piercing. Okay, so it is intended to smooth out the surface of a tube. Okay, this heart reeling is intended to smooth the outside of the surface of a tube. Okay, so this by heart reeling, so we can smoothen the outside of the surface of a tube. So the tube is supported on mandrel and is actually fed between two rolls. Okay, next, which are slightly oblique. Okay, which are slightly oblique. Next, the combination of squeezing and spinning operations. The combination of squeezing and spinning operations tends to increasing the diameter of the tube slightly. Okay, so the combination of squeezing and spinning operations tends to increasing the diameter of the tube slightly. So by the heart reeling processes. So we can see the diagram here. So this is the diagram of a heart reeling. okay, so we can see the grooved roller, okay, bent sculpt, next welded pipe, fixed mandrel. Okay, this is a diagram of a hot reeling. Okay, next we can see the some of the examples of hot reeling. Okay, smooth finished tubes like steel, aluminium, various alloy metals. Okay, next brass, copper. Okay, so all these are the some of the examples of smooth tubes. Next one is hot spinning. Okay, this is the sixth type of hot working processes. All right, so hot spinning is the process of shaping thin sheets of metals, okay, or blank. So hot spinning is a process of shaping thin sheets of metals blank by pressing against a rotating former. Okay, okay, next, the blank is held between former and the adapter. Okay, the blank, metal blank, is held between the former and the adapter. So the blanks rotates with the former. Okay, so when the blank rotates with the former. Okay, a specially shaped blunt tool is then pressed. Against the blank, the former, okay, against the blank, and slowly moves the cover, the former. Okay, next we can see the diagram of a hot spinning. Okay, this is the diagram of a hot spinning. Okay, so deformation of the metal during spinning is due to the combination effect of bending and stretching. Okay, so due to the bending and the stretching of the metal, okay, so the deformation of metal will take place. Okay, and the process is suitable for shaping ductile metals and alloys such as aluminium, copper, brass, and mild steels. Okay, you can see the figure here. So this process is extensively adopted to produce lamp reflectors. Okay, so this process is extensively adapted to produce lamp reflectors, cooking utensils, funnels, and containers used in chemical plants. Okay, so you can observe the figure here. So this is a diagram of a hot spinning. Okay, so you can see the parts of hot spinning: chuck, blank, former, tailstock, okay, pin, tool rest, hand tool, and headstock. All these are the examples of hot spinning. So next one is hot drawing or cupping. Okay, hot drawing or cupping. Right, so it is a process of making cup-shaped articles from a flat circular blanks. So it is a process of producing a
are making cup shaped articles from the flat circular blank. Okay, this is clear. Next, the heated blank is placed over the die. Okay, the heated blank is placed over the die. Next, the punch forces the blank. The punch forces the blank through a die to form a cup-shaped article or product. Okay, so the punch forces the metal blank through a die to form a cup-shaped article. Okay, so this is called hot drawing. You can see the diagram of hot drawing here. So this is at the place of placing a hot metal or hot blank, circular hot blank on the dies. Okay, so and by using punch, you can see here upper portion of the hot billet or blank, metal blank, this will be the punch. So by using a punch, we are applying some pressure on the hot billet so that the hot billet may become a U-shaped article or product. So here we can see, the diagram. Okay, so before it will looks like this. Okay, after applying the pressure on the hot billet or hot blunt or hot metal, the workpiece will, the product will looks like in the U shape. Okay, so here we can see in this second diagram. Okay, so examples we can see here. So hot drawing examples are hot cupping examples, seamless tubes, okay, thick walled cylinders, okay, cups, bezels. Okay, and the next is hot rolling. Next we can see the topic called hot rolling. Okay, right, so this hot rolling is the most efficient method of reducing the cross section area of large castings. Okay, so we can see here, so it converts, the hot rolling converts larger section into a smaller sections. Okay, so core structure of the cast ingot is converted into a fine grain structure, so it requires less power. Okay, it requires a less power. Okay, so rolling is more economical than forging. Okay, so it's required in long length of uniform cross section. So to improvement in physical properties such as strength, toughness, ductility, shock resistance. Okay, so it is suitable for metals for rolling: steel, aluminium, copper, magnesium alloys. Okay, so we can see here some of the hot rolling is useful to produce products of structural sections, sheets, rails, plates, bars, wires, etc. Okay, so we can see the each and every example here. So first one is sheet, we can see here. So here we are making or producing the sheets. Okay, so in this process, that is hot rolling process. Okay, so rolling, we can see the parts here. So first one is here, we can see
here we can see number one. Okay, number one is a roll bending jacks. Okay, so all number ones are known as roll bending jacks. Okay, so number two we can see. So so here we can see number two, trusometer measuring roll. Okay, this is called a trusometer measuring roll. Okay, this one. Okay, so third one is a signal transmission. So this will be the signal transmission. And fourth, control equipment. Control equipment for the trusometer measuring roll. Okay. Next, fifth, so display unit for strip shape. Okay, this is the fifth one. So display unit for strip shape. And here we can see sixth one, so coolants supplying. Okay, so roll coolant switching device. Okay, so this will be the roll coolant switching device. So by using this switching device, so we are supplying the coolants continuously. Okay, to overcome from the heat generated when performing the operations or producing the sheets. Okay, next we can see the preparation of rolls between the rollers. Okay, so here we can see the preparation of rails by using the rollers. Okay, so you can observe the figure here. This is done by the hot rolling process. Okay. Next one is preparation of bars by the hot rolling process. So we can also prepare the bars by using a hot rolling process. Okay, we can see the different sizes of the or different diameters of the bars here. Okay, next, preparation of wires. Okay, so we can see the preparation of wires in the hot rolling. Okay, all these are the bundles of wires. Okay, so we can also prepare the wires in hot rolling. Next, you can see. So rolling consists of passing a piece metal between two revolving cylinders or rollers. Okay, or you can see. So passing the hot ingot through two rolls rotating in opposite direction at a uniform peripheral speed. Okay, that is the hot rolling. You can see here, this is a diagram of a hot rolling. So from the original unworked grains, it is converted into the refined grains. Okay, it is reducing the diameter or thickness of the bar or workpiece. So by passing the bar in between the two rollers. Okay, you can observe the parts here. Okay, next, you can see the actual diagram here. Really, it looks like this. Hot rolling. So between these two rollers, okay, so between the upper roller and lower roller, the workpiece will passes from left to the right, so that it can reduce its diameter or it can refine grains. can getting it can make refined grains. So newly formed, okay, equalized grains, which have the crystallized from the deformed grains. So due to the very high rolling comparators. Okay. So this is the elongated grains. So due to plastic deformation here. Okay. Next, hot working processes. This is a procedure of hot working processes. You can see here. You can observe each and every part here. From this side, from right to left. Ladle. Okay. Next, into the mold. Just we are pouring the material into the ladle. Then it will pass to the mold. Okay. Or ingots. Okay. So from the rollers. So it is passing. It is water cooling rollers. You can see. Okay, you can observe the parts here, each and every part. So guide rolls, blooms, okay, so slab or ingots, okay, soaking pit. Next, blooming mill. Blooming mill. Then roughing mills. Then it is processed into the finishing mills. So there we can reduce, there we can make them into a rolls or sheets, rolled sheets, or coils of hotter rolled sheets. You can see here, this is a procedure of working processes. Okay, from here up to here. So after that, so make them into a sheet or coils or rolled sheets, hot rolled sheets. Okay, this is a working process of preparing a hot or sheets. Okay, next you can see this is also a working processes, sheet preparation. Okay, next here we can see, so preparation of rails. So by using different rolls, so preparation of rails. This is a working process for preparation of rails. Next, rolls are made of cast iron or steel. So it's mounted on cast iron. Okay. The space between the rolls is adjusted to conform to the desired thickness of the rolled sections. So we can also adjust the rolls between the rolls. Two rollers to make them into a desired thickness of the rails or work pieces. So between the two rollers. Okay. Next, adjusted by raising or lowering the upper roll. Okay, by adjusting the upper roll, so we can raise or lower the rollers. Okay, so that we can adjust the space between the two rollers. Next, the position of the lower roller is fixed. Okay, the direction of rotation is fixed and it can be reversed. Okay, next, work can be rolled by feeding from one direction only. Okay, so work can be rolled, work can be done by giving feed in the one direction only. Okay, next, reduced its cross section of the workpiece.
नेक्स्ट इंक्रीजिंग इट्स लेंथ, ओके ऑटोमेटिकली इंक्रीजिंग इट्स क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया लेंथ. नेक्स्ट सो डिफॉर्मेशन, प्लास्टिक डिफॉर्मेशन ऑफ मेटल टेक्स प्लेस. Have three types of hot rolling mills here. Okay, so now we can see the hot rolling mills. So three types of hot rolling mills are, so first one, two high rolling mills, second three high rolling mills, and third one is four high rolling mills. So these are the three types of rolling mills. Okay, hot rolling mills. You can see here. Okay. Next, we can see the two high hot rolling mill. Okay. So now we are going to discuss about the two high hot rolling mill. Okay. Right. So this is a diagram of a two high hot rolling mill. Okay, so we can observe the figure here. The two hot rollers are rotated in the opposite direction. Okay. The metal will pass through the two hot rolling mills so that it can reduce its cross section area, or we can increase the length. Okay, you can see the diagram here. Two high hot rolling mills. Direction of workflow. You can see the in the second diagram. Okay, right. So two high mill consists of two rolls and rotate in the opposite direction. Okay, so it is widely used for initial rolling of ingots. Okay. So initially we are using this type of rolling mills, that is two high hot rolling mills. Okay. Right. So it consists of two heavy horizontal rolls. So place exactly one over the other. Okay. Next, rolls rotates in opposite direction and are supported by stands. Okay, next, space between the rolls can be adjusted by raising or lowering the upper roll. Okay, the position of the lower roll is fixed, the direction of rotation is fixed and cannot be reversed. Okay, so work can be rolled by feeding from one direction only. Okay, so this is in two high hot rolling mills. Okay, so it is widely used for initial rolling of ingots. Okay, it is used for hot rolling in initial passes, so used on cast ingots, and also used in continuous casting. Okay, so rollers diameters are 0.06 meters to 1.4 meters. Okay. Next we can see the, this is the diagram of a three high rolling mills. Okay. Three high rolling mills. Okay, right. So first two rollers are similar to the two high rolling mills only. Okay, but the bottom one is the additional roller, okay, which is added to the two high rolling mill. Okay, so here द मेटल वर्क विल पास इन थ्रू द इन बोथ द डायरेक्शंस ओके सो फ्रॉम वन वन बिटवीन वन एंड टू एंड टू एंड थ्री रोलर्स ओके यू कैन सी हियर बाय ऑब्जर्विंग फिगर यू कैन ऑल्सो नो दिस इज ए थ्री हाई हॉट रोलिंग मिल ओके वर्क पास थ्रू बोथ द डायरेक्शंस या इन थ्री हाई हॉट रोलिंग मिल्स द टॉप एंड बॉटम रोल्स ट्रेड्स इन द सेम डायरेक्शन ओके द टॉप एंड बॉटम यू कैन ऑब्जर्व द फिगर हियर The first one and the third roller are rotates in the same direction. You can observe the figure. Okay, the top and the bottom rolls rotates in the same direction, and the middle roller rotates in opposite direction. Okay, so these three rollers are of equal size. Okay, these three rollers are of the equal size. And are arranged vertically above one another. Okay, the material being rolled, okay, the material being rolled passes between the middle and the bottom rolls. Okay, the material being rolled passes between the middle and the bottom rolls in one direction okay and is returned to the middle and top roll for further rolling okay middle is nothing but intermediate okay we can see here all the three rolls continuously revolves in the same fixed directions only so never rotate in reverse direction So material being rolled passes between the middle and bottom rolls in one direction. Okay, so returns to the middle and the top roll for further rolling. Okay, so it gives high rate of production than the two high mills. Okay, so these are used in billet rolling, blooming, finish rolling. Okay, so in this is the three high hot rolling mills so next one will four high hot rolling mill okay you can see the diagram here so here we have four rollers okay so here we have four rollers you can observe the figure here yeah You can see the parts, slab or plate from left side. Okay, so backup roll, work roll, and direction of movement of the workpiece, travel direction of this workpiece. In second diagram, you can see from right side diagram. Screw or hydraulic mechanism. This is a mechanism used for this one. Hydraulic or screw mechanism. Okay. Housing for the four high rolling mill. Okay. Chocks. Next, backup rolls. So top and bottom one will be there. You can call it as a backup rolls. Okay. So larger rolls are known as backup rolls here okay and the middle two are work rolls okay so between the two work rolls just we have to place the plate or slab or work piece so to pass between the two work rollers okay. Right same principles are okay so we can use here same principles okay say same principles as cluster mills or z mills ओके नेक्स्ट सो यू यूटिलाइज स्मॉलर रोल्स फॉर लोअर रोल फोर्सेस ओके ऑल्सो लोअर प्रेशर रिक्वायरमेंट एंड रिड्यूस स्पीडिंग ओके सो रोल्स आर चीप टू रिप्लेस ओके सो रोल्स आर चीप टू रिप्लेस सो स्मॉल रोल्स डिफ्लेक्ट मोर ओके सो दे मस्ट बी सेपरेटेड सॉरी सो स्मॉल रोल्स डिफ्लेक्ट मोर सो दे मस्ट बी सपोर्टेड बाय स्मॉल रोल्स स्मॉलर रोल्स ओके सो वरी अडॉप्ट फॉर कोल्ड रोलिंग टिन शीट्स हाई स्ट्रेंथ मटेरियल्स ओके इट कन्वर्ट्स इट कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ फोर हॉरिजॉन्टल रोल्स सो टू स्मॉलर डायामीटर रोल्स एंड टू लार्जर डायामीटर रोल्स ओके राइट सो अरेंज डायरेक्टली वन ओवर द अदर ओके फोर रोलर्स आर डायरेक्टली अरेंज्ड वन ओवर द अदर ओके सो लार्ज डायामीटर रोल्स आर कॉल्ड एज बैकअप रोल्स एंड मेन फंक्शन ऑफ लोअर रोल्स टू प्रिवेंट द डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द स्मॉल रोल्स ओके नेक्स्ट स्मॉल रोल्स आर वर्किंग रोलर्स स्मॉलर रोल्स आर दैट इज मिडिल रोलर्स आर नोन एज वर्किंग रोलर्स ओके सो कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड एट द टोटल रोलिंग प्रेशर ओवर द मेटल ओके यू कैन सी द पार्ट्स हियर ओके सो फोर हाई मिल कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ फोर रोल्स सो द लार्जर बैकअप रोल्स आर यूज्ड टू प्रिवेंट डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ स्मॉलर वर्किंग रोल्स ओके सो दिस टाइप ऑफ मिलिंग इज यूज्ड फॉर फ्लैट प्रोडक्ट्स एंड इट कैन बी ऑपरेटेड एज रिवर्सिंग और नॉन रिवर्सिंग मिल्स ओके सो व्हेन स्टैंड्स आर प्लेस्ड वन ओवर द अदर देन इट इज कॉल्ड ए कंटिन्यूस मिल्स सो हियर वी कैन सी द सम ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट्स प्रोड्यूस्ड इन रोलिंग मिल्स ओके सो वी कैन सी हियर इंटरमीडिएट रोल्ड फॉर्म टू फाइनल रोल्ड फॉर्म सो लेफ्ट साइड वी हैव ए इंटरमीडिएट रोल्ड फॉर्म मेटल्स और प्रोडक्ट्स एंड राइट साइड इट इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू ए फिनिश्ड और फाइनल रोल्ड फॉर्म्स ओके फाइनल रोल्ड फॉर्म प्रोडक्ट्स ओके सो ब्लूम टू स्ट्रक्चरल शेप्स दैट इज रेल्स नेक्स्ट स्लैब्स टू और प्लेट शीट्स ओके टू ए कॉइल्स एंड बिलेट टू द बार्स और रॉड्स ओके दीज आर द सम ऑफ द स्टील प्रोडक्ट्स मेड इन ए रोलिंग मिल ओके सो दिस इज द एंड ऑफ द सेमिनार टॉपिक नाउ आई विल स्टॉप हियर